guy that is willingly sticking his appendages inside the mouth of a live predator. Now, that does make a ton of sense. I would not want to cover myself either. However, there is a simple solution to that problem. All these places have to do is find somebody. Oh, you guys are waking up now. That's messed up. That is messed up. All they have to do is find somebody that is dumb enough to do it.
Good.
All right, now, I'm going to bring this guy above the water for everybody to see. All right, now, I want you guys to bear with me. Pretend that I am a Seminole man, and I have just captured myself an alligator. The next step for me, and as that Seminole man, would be to secure these jaws. I'm going to take my imaginary rope out of my back pocket, and I'm going to tie it around the alligator's mouth. But what do you need to tie a rope? Two hands to tie a rope. That means that something has got to hold the mouth. Shut! Who do we got by the door? Little girl right here. Do me a favor. Hop in the pit. Watch them too. They're pretty busy. Come hold this mouth shut real tight so that I can tie the rope to the ground. She's like, she doesn't understand. No. Listen, guys. I've been doing this for a week and a half. I watched the video on YouTube last night. I could have kept her safe. I'm kidding. I'm not going to make her do that. Remember, guys, the Seminoles were by themselves. They had to figure out a way to free up those two hands so that they could tie a rope around the alligator's mouth. Now, what they did was pretty interesting. The Seminoles would take their chest and their chin. They would place it over the mouth of the alligator, directly over all those teeth, because what could possibly go wrong? And they would hold that mouth shut, just like so. From a hunting technique into a show. That happened in about 1932. What happened was this. They built what's called the Tamiami Trail. That is the road that travels from Tampa and goes all the way down the Indian headquarters of the swamp. So tourists would drive by, and they would see a Seminole man on the back of an alligator. So of course, just like any of us would do, those guys pulled over. They asked questions, they took pictures, but here is the key. Those guys started to leave a little bit of money for gratitude. Concept board. Now, instead of using these animals for food, the Seminoles figured out they could keep them alive. They could use them for shows, they could teach people about their culture, and obviously get a little bit of money to feed their families that way. Well, it was not long before the Seminoles also figured out that the more dangerous the stunt they would do with the alligator, the more money the people would leave. So, for your entertainment, I am going to put my face right inside the alligator's mouth. That was late, ladies and gentlemen. That was late. Is that a bad idea? You can crush my head like a watermelon. I'm kidding, guys. I'm kidding. That is a sick joke. I don't do that. I don't do that until the end of the show. I got one. I'll take it. All right, what we're going to show you now is something called the close shave if it is done correctly. Otherwise, they call it face off. I'll let that sit in. All right, here we go.
Don't put your hands up.